I'm so excited for tonight. My name is Jen Katian, and I have the pleasure of serving as the President and CEO for Family Support Services. And this is the 11th year of the Just Like Me exhibition. If you have not been to one of these events before, you are in for a treat. These kids are incredibly talented. They have worked very, very hard over the last few weeks and really tried out all new different types of art modalities and learned a lot and taught, I'm sure, the support team a lot as well. And they are stepping out in great bravery and courage tonight to share with you their absolute best. And we couldn't be more proud of them and glad for what they have prepared for us today. So we are not going to take any more time. We are going to let the kids steal the whole show. But I wanted to introduce Ebony Payne-English at the Performers Academy. Ebony and the team here have just done an incredible job, as they have for many years. We could not do this without them. We would not want to. They are the masterminds behind all of the exciting things that you're going to see tonight. And we are so glad to have had their partnership for such a long time. So Ebony, take it away.
Thank you, Jen.
So peace and blessings, everyone. Welcome. I am so honored to be here sharing the 11th annual exhibition of talent for Just Like Me. It has truly been a journey and a labor of love, and I am so proud of what our teens are going to present tonight. The Performers Academy, it has a mission to share the power of the performing arts with the entire community, especially those who would not otherwise have access. A lot of times our teens are given artistic exposure and experience because it is a privilege and not used as a healthy coping mechanism and behavioral intervention. And we show things differently at the Performers Academy, and we allow them to tell autobiographical stories. So everything you see tonight is original content created by the students over 3 weeks. And everything that you feel from them tonight, I would love for you to return with love, energy, and encouragement. And we do an affirmation every day at Just Like Me Camp to start the day. And so just to get things started so that we are on the same plane, if y'all could repeat after me, I am whole and complete.
I am whole and complete.
I am divinely capable.
I am divinely capable.
Life is blessed by my presence.
Life is blessed by my presence.
And I am present.
I am present.
And I am ready.
I am ready.
And I am willing.
And I am willing.
Ashe. Please welcome Maria Oxford and Elizabeth McGillen from Family Support Services.
Good evening, everyone. On behalf of FSS and the Youth Wellbeing Department, we wanted to thank everyone that's been involved with this program. I've been in child welfare for about 10 years, but over the past 2 years, I've seen a side of this field that's truly inspiring, from everything, including the outstanding caregivers to our incredibly talented teenagers. So I wanted to give gratitude and recognition to a couple different groups, but I do want to start with our outstanding teen foster parents. This would not be possible without you all. You pour love and support, and you teach and love our kids day in and day out. So we can't thank you enough for everything that you pour into our teens. Yes. Next, I'd like to thank the sponsors, the Performers Academy, Department of Children and Families, Kids Hope Alliance, and of course our partners in the system of care. The Guardian Ad Litem Program, Department of Children and Families, Children's Legal Services, the Judiciary, and of course our CMO partners, Jewish Family and Community Services, Daniel, National Youth Advocate Program, and our case management in Nassau at FSS. Next, I'd like to give a huge shout out to our transporters, everyone who helped transport the teens to and from camp every week. Thank you, thank you, thank you. It would not have been possible without you. From everyone from caregivers, case managers, CMO staff, FSS staff, thank you very much. A big shout out to Jack's party bus, David and Mr. Rashad, who worked so well with us in getting a bulk of our teens to travel to and from camp every day on a party bus, so it's a lot of fun. Next, I'd like to give a special thank you to Elizabeth McGillen and Oliver Green. Oliver is the youth well-being supervisor, and Liz is our program coordinator. The preparations that go into this is a lot. So they have made sure that everything is taken care of, the logistics, the transportation, all the things that go into preparing for this camp. So I can't thank you enough for making this a huge success. Yes. Next, I want to thank our extremely talented teenagers who I know are eagerly awaiting to get on this stage, so I'm going to wrap this up soon, I promise. They've done an outstanding job over the last 3 weeks, so I know they're very excited to get out here and showcase what they've done. I do like want to thank Ebony and Catherine, who have done an outstanding job at the Performers Academy and with this camp, for our incredible partnership with FSS. The passion that they have for these young adults and for the community is astounding, and this is an incredible camp, and we couldn't have done this without them. Lastly, I want to thank the community and all of you for coming out tonight, for supporting our teens. Thank you for being here, and if you are interested in hearing more about FSS, adoption, or licensing, we have a table outside afterwards if you guys want to hear anything. And lastly, enjoy the show.
So this year's theme is reality shows, and it's meant to be a double entendre, right? Because reality shows are a major part of popular culture. And also, Just Like Me is a camp about autobiographical artistic stories. And so it's basically our youth showing their realities.
About them old days, looking in the now, wearing all these gold chains, trying to make a way, trying to get away from all the fakeness. People dissing on me every day, I can't take this.
Like, we write songs, we write poems, we're writing monologues. It must be whatever it is that they need to get off their chest.
You had a singing hook on the first one. Yeah. But go back to your original.
It was basically fixed my thoughts into to make good sense. If that makes sense to you.
It makes sense, dude.
Yes.
It's called rehabilitation time.
Yes.
The goal is to take anything that you want to say and make it beautiful.
We need to make sure that there's only one voice, because we want to make sure that the person that's blindfolded can hear the instruction from the person that's not blindfolded.
You won't break my soul. You won't break my soul. Ain't taking no flicks, but the whole click snapped. There's a whole lot of people in the house trying to smoke with the yak in your mouth. And we back outside. You said you outside, but you ain't that outside. Worldwide hoodie with the mask outside, in case you forgot how we act outside.
And motivation. I'm gonna found me a new.
I've already seen really big improvements over the course of 2 hours, 3 hours of students who say they've never drawn before, never danced before, never made a beat before.
One, two, and no. One, and two, and three, and four, and no. One, two, three, four, whole note.
Now, you're gonna hit that button. That's recording everywhere. That's telling the computer you're ready to record.
She's recording, okay? You're performing. You're not recording.
So I want you to perform it every time, and we're going to capture that.
I gave you flowers through the night when you needed it. You never noticed when they died, only missing in the vase we bought for our anniversary. Say flowers were only for big apologies.
Okay, turn it off.
Yeah, turn you off. Always thought I'd make a fool of someone else. Now you've gone and then you made me make one of myself.
Boom. That's it.
Because love got us messed up.
No, love got you messed up. It made me who I am.
It made me act more crazy.
What about the song?
Because I can relate to it.
Always thought I'd make a fool of someone else. Now you've gone and made me make one of myself.
Skip to my loop.
Okay?
I'm just very happy and blessed and thankful for the both of them, honestly. And I cannot wait to do Beyonce with them.
Don't forget your walk, so let's go over the flat foot walk. So two flat, two tippy toes, one dip, okay? All right?
This dance, it fits us perfectly. It's feminine. It has a touch of sexy and power, and it's just, we just get to have fun with it, and we get to do our own poses in certain parts of it.
And walk, and two, and three, and four, and five, now six, wrap, then hit, then you dip, hit, and hit, pose.
The end starts to get, you know, a little hard, because it goes fast, so you know, you gotta put your mind to it.
Beat, two, three, four, five. Seven, eight.
Even the stuff that she has had us do that isn't us doing freestyle, it still feels like it's just us doing us.
Just Like Me is a camp for teens, and it really helps us to have an outlet and to be able to express ourselves in our most authentic way and really discover our passions.
It doesn't have to look like anything. It could just be random. We're just gonna fill it up. We can make it look like this butt. Yeah, so we're gonna collaborate with Miss Denisha's class and do a little fashion show. So we're gonna be designing the fabric, and then she's gonna create some cool clothing out of the fabric, some bags, some skirts, all that good stuff.
So now you're gonna start zipping straight, and you're gonna learn how to control your feet.
Look, you know, it's all about the money, and the zebra skin. Zebra, whatever skin this is.
I was wanting to ask, if I make my own personal school, would that be acceptable?
Oh yeah, if you want to do that, that's fine. That's what it's all about. And it's the first pattern she created for her pen cushion.
Whenever you get the hang of it, it's super easy and you knock things out.
It's just fabulous. I mean, who doesn't want fashion? Everybody gets dressed every day, and why not look like the best everywhere you go? So
the pattern is telling you that it wants you to cut it one whole piece.
To make you open the fold part of it.
Yes.
Okay.
So that way when you make your face mask, the whole middle part is one piece.
Growing up, we didn't have money like that, so we couldn't just go out and get like nice, new, up-to-date things. We had to make work of what we had, so I picked up sewing, and it made us have more money than what we had, so we could go out more, maybe get a nice dinner one night, and it really helps.
And I have all my pin stuff.
And now she made her pin cushion.
What is a pin cushion?
It's a miniature pillow that you stick your pins in when you're not using them, so they're not just laying around.
There you go. Now it won't be twisted, and you're ready to go. I got patience for it.
It does take patience, but the rewards when you're done, it's the happiest moment of all that you completed something.
And now we have a runaway student in here. Come on, come on in the camera. See, everybody runs away to fashion class because they know that fashion is their passion.
She came up with the idea of what a perfect family is supposed to look like or not look like.
I hope that one day they will see this and know that not every family is perfect. Zoning back into the chaos, sitting there wondering what those loud words I hear them talk. That's when I see blood dripping from my mother's face, and for a while I thought it would all be okay. But now I'm looking out the window at another family, and the only blood I see is on a scraped knee. Why should I be the only kid sitting here? And for a while, I scream.
You know, I tell them to take all that pain, all that anger, and we try to put it on the paper, you know what I'm saying, and turn it into art. And that's the whole purpose of the camp, to be honest. You know, these kids are just like me, and it's, you know, it's the way I channel my hurt and issues. And you know, I just think it could be a good tool for them. You know, instead of being angry and punching walls and so forth, you know, we can put it down on the paper. You know?
Because when it comes to adoption, all the families want young kids because they don't have trauma. But we have hundreds of thousands of loving teenagers who do have issues in their own right. It was just the cards they were handed, and it's not fair that they get that the families that are looking to adopt just completely overlook the teens, because we just want a family too.
I've been struggling, but I'm gonna get through it, because, you know, it is a better situation where I'm at now, but even through foster care, you still have people with their prejudices. Music's kind of my escape from everything. Anytime I'm feeling down, just sing a song, play a tune, I'll feel a lot better.
Y'all, we have to get along. We have to work together.
You got a big head.
I don't care. Get out of my room.
Big head. Why can't y'all just get along? We're supposed to be a family.
Because I don't care. I don't care. Why do y'all keep talking to me? I don't care.
Okay, scene. All week I've been giving them games that give them some structure, and then they can invent within it. We're creating original material. So that's why you need to build improv skills.
What gets me fired up is when people just bother me for no reason. When they didn't got nothing to say, they just wanna bother you. What gets me fired up is when you don't use your brain. What gets me fired up nowadays is like when I'm cleaning and you see I'm cleaning, but you wanna get in my way. What gets me fired up is when I'm sitting down. Okay, that's all.
He was focused, he made great eye contact, and he didn't take a breath in between, but that makes sense for that particular prompt.
Working with her actually opens up my voice. It makes me talk louder. I feel loved here. I love the energy that everyone's showing.
Player two, face right. Extend your right arm toward player one and open your right hand.
May the Lord repel you, the demon in you. Holy water. That's all.
Okay. Please. I feel like it's a way to express myself. I feel like it's something that makes me feel good about myself, being able to just like express myself through acting or through telling a story. It just makes me feel good.
The downs are the first. One, two, three, four, five, yep, six, seven, watch, eight, and.
From the valley to the sea.
You have to make me believe.
When you look at a woman.
There you go.
There's so much you don't see.
Yeah. I'm learning how to express myself through dance. And I feel like I would never be able to do that if it wasn't for the people that are here. They're wonderful. Learning how to express my feelings, my emotions, how I feel, like all that, you know. Been a really good way to express myself and my feelings.
There you go. need to break it down to your heart and let me know. Seven, oh, that works as well too. Or that.
Just Like Me is very fun because, like, you have two options and you can pick the different disciplines and, like, you can try new things. And it just brings out your true colors.
It's cool meeting, like, other people who are going through some of the same situations as me, because having someone who you can easily relate to really helps when you're going through a hard time.
I always love seeing Just Like Me because you can see the kids at the beginning of camp and how much they open up during camp. They really come out of their shells, they really, like, express themselves, and that is my favorite part about Just Like Me, is to see them actually be able to come out of those shells and express what they want to express through the arts.
Honestly, I feel like kids that are in foster care, they need this. Like, they need this part of, it's okay to be me. It's okay to show that I'm different, but I can also be myself. They need that 3 weeks of realization to be themselves.
If you got a chance, take it. Take it while you got a chance. If you got a dream, chase it. 'Cause a dream won't chase you back. If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can, till you can.
To have such a diverse group of students come together and achieve something so great is something that is extremely rare and precious. And I'm just honored to be able to live my dreams, because my youth are my life's work. This is my life's work. And to see it come to fruition in such a way is momentous, and I'm grateful. That's it.
If you're gonna love somebody, hold them as long and as strong and as close as you can, till you can.
Just Like Me is very cool and I really enjoy it.
Support. I am Denisha Sylvester. I am the fashion teacher for TPA, and I am super excited. Let's give them another hand.
These students have accomplished something in 2 weeks that normally takes anywhere from 6 to 12 weeks. So when I tell you they did the work, blood, sweat, and tears, right? They did the work, they got on the sewing machines, and we had no accidents. Nobody sewed their hand together, isn't that great? We had no issues. We had lots of runaway students trying to come in our class. But we had to focus ourselves on the fashion. So in front of me, Miss Kaden is wearing a social media gown. Come on, give it a spin. Yes. This was a collaboration from our student Skylove, as well as all the other fashion students. Next, we have Miss Jasmine in her infinity dress. Yes. And the amazing thing about this dress, it can be tied over 30 different ways, so she literally has like 30 dresses in one. Then we have Mr. Carlito. Yes. He is one who designed some fabric. Actually, show them the bag. One of our other fashion students who could not be here tonight, Mario, he actually, Mario, stand up, stand up. Give him a hand, guys. He painted that fabric. Yes, Mario, and we miss you. See, he didn't want y'all to know who he was, but it's over now, it's too late. And Carlito is wearing his custom fashion logo. He created his logo. Then we have Miss Kennedy, and yes. And she is wearing the fabric that we collaborated with the art class. Yes, and the rest of our students are our fashion mobbers. You know how paparazzi follows all of the famous people. So let's give our paparazzi a hand. And thank you all so much for coming tonight and enjoy the show.
Naomi! Tonight, I am hoping that you give a great performance by Muskroom, and I hope it is worth seeing.
Well, we certainly do. Thank you. Now, we do have a special treat. We love to go behind the scenes and hear from our contestants and know a little bit about their journey and how they ended up on our show. So let's all peek in and listen.
Hello again. Didn't think I'd make it back here for the finals. Really excited to be here. Hopefully I can see my friends. Biggest motivation for music are my two best friends, Jason Dillon. They came out here to support me on my music journey. Started when I was 5. My first instrument was the harp. Very difficult instrument to play. But I started because it was, with my great-grandmother in church. But even past that, my grandfather had a music shop. So I've always grown up around instruments. And I've always, enjoyed learning to play them. I played steel drums, normal drums, guitar, bass, ukulele, every instrument under the sun. But it really wasn't fulfilling enough until I turned 9, where I was able to start songwriting. And being able to write songs was really a freeing experience because it allowed me to have a voice that I wouldn't have otherwise had. And I'm excited to share what that's led me to tonight.
What an amazing story. Started writing at 9. Kevin, when did you start telling jokes?
Well, let's be honest. I've been telling jokes my whole life. I mean, I was treated as a joke because I am the joke, obviously. But, my life is pretty good. Telling jokes. Living life.
And you and the pebble, you're really close, aren't you?
Uh-huh. I'm close with the rock, too.
Yeah. Yes, big rocks and pebble. What about streams?
Streams, I drown.
Well, everyone's streaming your shows. And Naomi, what did you think about Mushroom's background?
I feel like it was very informational, and I feel like I am very excited for the show today. I hope it is worth seeing. I wasn't really into instruments, but I was more of a dancer and more into fashion. So I'm hoping you learn a lot.
Great. Well, without further ado, we're going to bring Mushbloom on for her live performance. She will be performing an original song, Owls. Give it up!
And bound to the ground, no freedom in sight. Lost my love, my life, and I'm probably gonna lose this fight. But I know that I can't escape if I make it out alright. But it's hard to see when you're beaten down, yeah, the world just ain't right. And they said hide away, little lonely, then hide. If you can, then you'll be okay. But I tried and tried to make it out alive, and I still stay.
I honestly, I've never been speechless a day in my life, but today is
yeah, me either.
I am speechless. That was an amazing performance. Even with the quote unquote mess up, yes, there's never mess ups in life. There, that was just.
I can't believe she's speechless.
As some kids say these days, you snapped.
I love just like your voice, it's beautiful. I wish I was like you, to be honest. But I'm not gonna lie, I give it a zero. No, I'm kidding. That was amazing. That was just amazing. 10 out of 10.
Just Like Me Camp. This is my third year here, and I have to say it's by far the best year that I've had, and probably the best group that I've had so far. Okay, clap it up. And, you know, we only had three short weeks, but in that time, I'm so proud of what the students accomplished. The biggest thing that I can ask for as an instructor is just participation. And everybody did that 150%. So normally, so this is my third year here. I'm going to do it a little different this year. So behind me, as you can see, I have two easels set up. So since my kids did so good and they were so talented, I thought I should battle one of them on stage in front of everybody.
Yeah.
Y'all think about that?
Yeah.
Test. So I'm going to introduce you to a few of my students, and then we're going to see who has the guts to go against the master artist.
Yeah.
All right, so first up, let's bring up Miss Janae. Yeah, so Janae, she was my student who tried to trick me into believing that she had no artistic ability. But she came out doing these amazing sunsets and landscape paintings. And I knew she had it in her, she didn't know, but she knows now. Next up, we're gonna have Jasmine. And so Jasmine, in any class she was in, she was like the life of the party. So she kept the art class laughing and entertaining. Next up, we're gonna have Kennedy. Kennedy was the quiet one. She kind of kept everything together in the class. I called her the class president. All right, next up, Carlito. Carlito, he's a true artist, as you can see. You know, we always do something different. I have the vest and he has the mask. Carlito, he created like his own gallery. So in the art classroom, he has his own wall full of paintings. Like every day he would come in and get to work and like be pumping out a new painting like every second. Okay, last but not least, Aiden. I had Aiden last summer. I think last summer Aiden maybe did like one painting. This summer, I don't know what got into Aiden. He went a little crazy. Aiden has like 15 or 20 paintings in the classroom. Let's see who the lucky challenger would be. What about you, Jasmine?
What?
Janae?
What?
Aiden?
What about you? Okay.
Carlito? Kenny? Think about Kenny.
Come on.
All right. Come on up, Kenny. So how this will work is we're going to get 1 minute. We're going to set the timer. We're We're going to get started painting, and we're going to have the audience vote. So at the end of the timer, we're going to flip the canvases around, and you guys vote by a round of applause. So since I'm going to win, I don't want to embarrass Candy too much. I know I'm the art instructor, I'm the adult here, so we're supposed to go easy on the kids, but like, this is my job. So I do this for a living, and I have a reputation to uphold, so I can't go easy on you, Candy. All right, here we go. So I'm going to hand this mic over to Jasmine along with the timer. Carlito, you got my golden paintbrush?
Y'all ready? You ready, Kennedy? All right, ready, set, go.
Come on, Kennedy.
Come on, Candy, you got this. I want to hear everyone applause for Kennedy since she got this.
Come on, man. Come on, Kennedy.
Kennedy.
Seconds.
Come on, Kennedy.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, brush is down.
All right, since I already won, I'll turn my canvas around first. Make this easy for Kennedy. She hasn't had to take a long walk of shame. That was a weak applause. I think y'all just don't know art. Y'all don't know anything about art. See what Kenny.
Told me I was brave, told me I was smart, and it was easy to misbehave. Took my untapable hair and showed me how to make a braid. You'll shape my life with the path that you paved. Full of inspiration, I'd be lost without you. Mom, I learned to understand you and never to doubt you. You helped me through my downfalls and always praised me. I had a daughter and I'd raise her the way that you raised me. Being a single mother will never get easier, trying to make her smile and constantly pleasing her. But you showed me support even if I was a little wild. Guess it runs in my blood, remember? I am your child. Everything you do will always be appreciated. Stood by my side with all the losers that I dated. And in a couple years, I'll be done and graduated. And Mom, I always love you, and it's because of you I made it.
From the valley to the sea, when you look at a woman,
My name is Mr. West. I'm Moses West. I am the lyricism teacher, and being the extremely awesome teacher that I am, I decided to do the hard job, you know, the lyricism. And it's not always the most fun job, especially with the music and the dance and all the fun stuff that go on in camp, but it's the dirty work. It involves getting in touch with your emotions and letting it out and putting it on paper, you know. We spend a lot of time writing, we spend a lot of time talking, we spend a lot of time in complete silence in our class. And during the time, you know, we get to talk on deeper levels and we get to know each other. And, you know, we talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly. And I got to know this young lady over the past 3 weeks, and she is wise beyond her years. She's dope, she's talented, and she's just an awesome lyricist. So I want to, everybody, y'all give it up for Sophia.
Hello, my name is Sophia, and I will be reading an original poem called The Perfect Family. Looking through my window at the perfect family, wondering what I did to deserve this. I hope that maybe one day they will see this and not know and know that not every family is perfect. Zoning back into the chaos, wondering what those loud words mean. But that's when I see blood dripping from my mother's face. And for a while, I thought it would be okay. But now I'm looking out the window at another family, and the only blood I see is on a scraped knee. So now I have to sit here and watch, feeling as if I'm the only kid here. And for a while, I scream. I cry knowing that this isn't fair. And I know me and this kid are the same. So I wonder why we are so different. You may be physically be bleeding, but I sit here every day, and every piece of me will eventually break away and decay, because mental pain never goes away. So please remember, if I look at you, it's not because I envy you, but because I hate you. Now if I seem mean, I'm sorry. There's just pain in my past that you would never understand. You say you hate your family? Well, imagine not having it. My daddy was too busy paying the bills. My stepmom was making my life a living hell. My other mommy left me for another man. Baby brother is learning to throw hands. Teachers wondering why you're showing up with bruises. Friends and family think they're just excuses. But see, there is no family. They are the ghost of one. Or so I thought they were. A family has a loving dad and a mom that cares. A brother who's got your back instead of stabbing me there. I'm sorry if I act mean, but it's not because I hate you, but because I envy you. Now you're probably wondering why I wrote this poem. And it's because of the foster system and the adoption system. The kids in foster care, they're loving, bright, and smart. But they have so much trauma, and I am so sorry if you do not understand this. People from 0 to 7 always get adopted, but we have teens from 7 to 18 that would love to have a family. But we have trauma. You guys make up excuses saying we smoke or we're always in sexual activity. But that is because of our trauma. And I am deeply sorry if you do not understand this.
Something.
No. That was very selfish. You
could have came in accident.
Well, selfish is like not eating my good girl.
Not shellfish, selfish.
Yeah.
Okay?
Well, shellfish is you not eating my girl.
That. I'm gonna walk away, like my therapist tells me to do. I'm gonna call DoorDash, okay?
Well, I'm gonna have a shell of a time.
Have a shell of a time by yourself.
Well, I made this good behind gumbo. Any of y'all want to eat it with me?
Yeah.
But anyways, you see how I'm living this life like,
they don't want to eat my gumbo.
Oh my God. This is gonna stress me out. People are so inconsiderate. Does anybody have the Wi-Fi password? Literally, this is gonna make me mad. People don't know how to do anything around this house. Nobody cleans up, nobody does anything. And now they wanna change the Wi-Fi password. It just doesn't make any sense. Does anybody have the Wi-Fi password? Ask one more time. Does anybody in this house have Wi-Fi password?
What are you doing? I just mopped this floor.
I wouldn't care. That sounds like a problem.
So that's the person with a U problem too.
Yes, I have a U problem and I'm looking for the Wi-Fi.
I guess you have to view never mind.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Now I have to remop this floor and retrace your steps. So retrace it to the room.
Peace out.
Peace. People these days, I swear, no common sense.
I got the weather for a song, and baby, you're a goal. Nobody can take me easy. I got the weather for a soul, and baby, you're a goal. Nobody can take me easy. The stirring of the woods won't give a rest. The Friday night went really dark, really dark. The stirring of the woods won't give a rest. Hello, my name is Cyril Brown. Who were you all my life? You stood by me with my eyes. Nobody can take me. Oh, my life. You stood by me with my eyes. Nobody can take me down. Nobody, nobody, yeah. Nobody can take me down.
Now,
I got fired for a heart. I'm not scared of the dark. I've never seen it blur so easy. I got a river for a soul. And maybe you're a goal. Maybe you're my only reason.
Fire in heaven, will there be nothing left? The shell of a man could never be met. If I didn't have you, we'll never see the sun. No time we have to be someone.
Can't tell.
We went on a tear into the park. I wanted to scream and pour out my heart. But then we went behind a tree and I look in your eye. But the passion in my head almost nearly died. Then we kissed, so maybe you would be excited. You got me hoping maybe one day you would need me. And then we pulled away and left me in the open, regarding the initial scar by you and me.
Almost you. Almost you.
If you come through the tunnel when you need it, you never notice when they die. You'll be missing it. The days before for our anniversary, the flowers were only for bigger flowers. I gave you flowers and I put it in a vase, saying that I loved you and I never had to wait. The kind of love you had was yours for someone else, and the kind of trust you wrote was tucked away on a shelf. When you go and you say that you're excited, I go and think that maybe this could finally be the end. Cause I know I could never say no to you, because you broke me down, now you realize that my words are true.
Misery means to be my muse. I have a new tattoo. It is placed just above my left breast. It is beneath flesh. It is lightning bolts scarred through the center of my heart. I am healing. You have bloomed into the most beautiful bud I've ever had. The most friendly lover leaves thorn prints in my skin when I squeeze too tightly, when I release too wildly. When I don't know how to hold you close. Closed palm is too close to keep. I fear that we've drifted too deep to breathe. I am unrested during our reprieves, although safer when I'm alone. I feel at home, curled feeble into the touch cuddle of your arms, and I want to belong there. I long to feed from the fruit of this labor. Instead, I am starving for attention, mainly to detail. I know quite well how we do, but what we are doing is a mystery. You have taught me an exemplary fashion about acceptance. I feel tested on my cognition of the unacceptable. I would love to flow freely like streaming ivy, green chakra shock waves over, under, and through anything that separates you. Are you here, love? Will you stay, love? Are you afraid, love? Me too.
As long as you, as long as you.
So it's my pleasure to introduce another magnificent talent and person that I got the opportunity to get to know over camp. This is Aiden. Aiden is a music production student for the second year. And he's the strong, silent type. He don't speak much, but he says a lot through his artwork. So he got me up here talking for him. He don't want to talk on the microphone. Like, he just speaks through his art. So what we're going to do is we're going to show him our appreciation through our body language. Aiden makes music. He made some beats during camp. And we're going to play a couple of his instrumentals for him. And we're just going, you know, we're going to vibe to it. We're going to nod our heads. We're going to sway. We're going to snap our fingers. And we're going to let him know that we appreciate what he does. Aiden, y'all.
Hey,
thank you.
we can't see y'all at all from up here. So we don't know if y'all was bobbing, we don't know if y'all was vibing with us, but we got another one to play for y'all. And this is gonna be our next super music producer right here standing next to y'all. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna clap for that during the next beat so we can hear it. We can't see you, but we're gonna make some noise for Aiden. Let's play the second.
And this was a game that we played, and this became their favorite game, where I would give them phrases and that would trigger memories, and then I just would give them one word, and that word would just take them into sort of a reverie, and they would start remembering things from when they were 5 or 8 or 9, and they would say, I said, what game do you want to play? Give us one word. Give me a word. We're going to end with two improvised monologues. They each have their words, and give it up for Kaden and Marquise.
Hi, I'm Kaden.
I remember.
So, as a kid, I used to love my great-great-grandma. We used to go over there and do yard work and then eat. She always leave us outside in mosquitoes. But so I went with my brothers, my sisters, my mom, and we went on a road trip, and my grandma. We was on our way to Georgia, and my mom got pulled over and arrested, so she was in jail for a little bit. So my grandma took over, and she drove us to our great-great-grandma. So when we got there, we did yard work, we cut the grass, we saw a few kitties, we stole one. We worked hard, and then we ate, and we ate outside. But she actually, surprisingly, it was like our first time, and we'd been there 100 times. We actually went in the house and got to see the house. We got to sit out in the house. And so we went outside, finished our work, and we got ready to leave and stuff. And then we got to the house. A few days later, my great-great-grandma wasn't feeling well, and she was down with a really bad fever or whatever because she had cancer. And so my grandma came over there and, like, you know, comforted her. And, you know, she slept over there, whatever, stayed over there for a few days. And next thing you know, my great-grandma and my grandma were asleep, and my great-great-grandma had passed away in her sleep. And so we got the news an hour later, and so we had a funeral, we had a cremated. And basically, that's all.
I remember one time my Nana was in the hospital, and mind you, my Nana, she's a very strong woman. She's very capable of doing a lot of great things. She has 7 grandchildren, including me. And she is one of my number one idols. And I remember one time she got put in the hospital because she wasn't feeling very well. And next thing you know, I asked my mom, like, well, can I stay with Nana? May I please just stay with Nana, stay a night with Nana at the hospital? So I went to stay with my Nana. I woke up, and I was looking out the window because I was just like, because the hospital was right by the St. John's River, and so you could see a lot of water. So I was looking out the window, just looking at the water, and I looked back at my grandma. She was laid down asleep. And next thing you know, I go and I see 2 dolphins jump across. Mind you, my grandma, she is a big fan of dolphins. She loves dolphins a lot, just like she loves the color purple. And I remember just like screaming. I was like, Nana, there's 2 dolphins. They jumped across, like there's dolphins. And so she had woke up. She wasn't really able to get out of her bed, but she did wake up, and I was up. She was like, take a video. And so I tried to take the video. I got pirated a dolphin, and all I know is a few days later, my Nana was well. She was okay. She was out of the hospital. She was able to be the great grandma that she is to all of her grandchildren. She is, like I said, she's my number one inspiration, and I love my Nana very much. So I just felt like that was a very memorable day, and I feel like that was one of the days that I could feel like that will forever be in one of my core memories. And I just want to say to my family and my friends that it's okay to feel sad when a family member is in the hospital, and trust me, I know, because my nana's in the hospital right now. She isn't feeling very well. And it's just, as long as you work hard, pray, keep motivation, keep doing the things you love, that one family member who you feel like is not feeling well or is in the hospital or is just not the best person they can be, I feel like the motivation that you give off and the motivation that you give to other people that they can give off to her or him or whoever it is, I feel like that's one thing that will really help that person. And I know that being in foster care has been very hard, not being able to be around my siblings or be around my grandma or being around my mom and my auntie. And even my cousins, God knows my cousins are just annoying sometimes. But just being around them makes me feel happy, it makes me feel okay. So I want to encourage people who are in foster care, who are in the system, who have a hard time struggling with anything, that if you keep motivating yourself and if you keep pushing towards what you have to do, you will be A-okay and you will get back to what you need to do. So that is my story of I Remember.
Violet Mushroom.
I remember.
Janae.
I remember.
Mario.
I remember.
Skyler.
I remember.
Kennedy.
I remember.
Jasmine Nicole.
I remember.
Sophia.
I remember.
Allison.
I remember.
Ada.
I remember.
Carlito.
I remember.
Cadence.
I remember.
Savannah.
Big shout out to Maria and Elizabeth and Amarun for making this journey easy and blessed for all of us. I'd like to thank our board chair, Catherine D. McAvoy at the Performers Academy and all of our great board members. I'd like to thank the JLL production manager, Dr. Sean Holland Powell. I would like to thank the fashion design teacher, Ms. Denisha Sylvester. I would like to thank the JLM camp counselor, Ms. Jasmine Dukes. I would like to thank the JLM theater and teaching artist, Barbara Babs Colicello. I would like to thank the visual arts teaching artist, not just for JLM, but for Squad Goals, Mr. Christopher Clark. I would like to thank the TPA, JLM and Squad Goals lyricism instructor, Mr. Moses West. Thank the JLM dance teaching artist, Marlon Easy Smith. I would like to thank the JLM and Squad Goals dance teaching artist, Ms. Anaya Incarnacion. I would like to thank the TPA program assistant, Ms. Janae Collins. And I would like to also thank our recording arts teaching artists for JLM and TPA, all of our programs really, Travis Thomas, who cannot be here tonight. And last but certainly like least, I would like to thank Sophia. Come here. I would like to thank Allison. I would like to thank Carlito. I would like to thank Janae. I would like to thank Violet Mushroom. I I would like to thank Savannah. I would like to thank Aiden. I would like to thank Kennedy. I would like to thank Jasmine Nicole. She killing him in that dress. I would like to thank Marquise. And I would like to thank my Kate and Sonny. We would like to thank the Florida Theater for being such gracious hosts for all of us this evening. Thank you to Kids Hope Alliance, the Cultural Council of Greater Jacksonville, the City of Jacksonville, continuing to support our mission. I see you, Kendra. We miss you, Kendra. Thank you for being here tonight. We love you. Good night.
On behalf of FSS, we would like to thank you, Ebony, for all your hard work. And we have a rose for each member of the camp. Thank you.